Hi, my name is Jessie. Now I will represent my our group to present the part of discussion. So let us start. Okay, we can know that based on the graph, there is no trend, no seasonality. So we have used the approximate forecasting method of simple exponential smoothing to forecast the data. Okay, let us start to calculate the data. First, before we start to calculate the forecast data, we need to write down the data and the actual data. We need to write down lah. So after write down these two columns, we need to write the forecast data, residual or error value, absolute error, and the square error. Okay, before we start to calculate, we have some formula we need to use when we can see here, which is ft plus m equal to alpha times xt plus 1 minus alpha times ft. Okay, for forecast equal to alpha times previous value or divide or actual value plus 1 minus alpha times previous forecast. Okay, for the alpha is equal to the smoothing constant. Okay, alpha must between 0 and 1. The range between 0 and 1. So for xt is equal to the actual value now. Okay, for ft is forecast value for the period. Okay, let us start to calculate the forecast data. Okay, for the first one is this one. Okay, C3. Right, you just the first forecast data you just need to write before write same like the actual data. You just copy, just write equal. Then B3, or you just need to just copy and paste also can two ways you can use. Okay, after that the second forecast data they have some formula we can see here. And the formula is equal I1 times B3 plus I2 times C3. Okay, where what is I1? Okay, we can see here I1. Okay, I1 is alpha. We use the alpha is 0.7. Then 1 minus alpha is 0.3. Okay, so we use the alpha and 1 minus alpha to do the forecast data. Okay, we just do and do. Okay, we see the third, this one. Okay, why we need to log it? Because if we didn't log the equation or the value, then we just double click here, drop down, then the rest answer will become zero or become no value. So we must do log here, then we double click here, then all the answer will come out and won't become the no value or just become zero. Okay, after calculate the forecast data, we go to the next residual or error value. So what is the formula for this one is we can see here. Okay, residual or error value is equal to actual data minus not equal minus the forecast data. Okay, you can see here how to do. If you see the first one, B4 minus C4 means that actual data B4 minus forecast data C4 then will become the residual error. Okay, this one no need to log because they didn't have the time, so we just need to double click here or drop down, then the answer will come already. You can see here. Okay, the next one is to calculate the absolute error. Okay. What is the absolute error value? So equations we can see here is type ABS. ABS means absolute times residual data. Okay, how to do? We can see here the equation is absolute ABS D4. You just click ABS, type ABS, then you click D4, then answer will come out already. You can see here. Sorry, you see here. The value will come out already. So you also don't need to log any things. You just need to double click, then all the answer will come out. You can see here. Okay, we can see the absolute error is all is positive value. Didn't have any negative value. If you get the negative value, that means that you have get the wrong answer, so you need to redo. Okay. So the next one is square error. Okay, what is the square error solution equations? Okay, we can see here is absolute Square root error is equal to absolute value times 2. Okay, how to times 2? You can see here. Okay, just click E4. No, just click this one, then you see a formula here. E4 times 2. Okay, E4 times 2 means this one, not times 2, is square 2. Square 2, then you get this answer. This one is means square, not times. Square 2. So you get the answer, and you just double click it and get the answer here. Okay, this one also only can get a positive answer. If you get a negative answer, means that you have get the wrong value for it. Okay, after we done to calculate the forecast data or until the square error value, so we need to follow the absolute value here until the here to write the MRD. Below the square error value, you need to write the MSE, and beside that, you need to write the RMSE. You need to write RMSE here. Okay. Okay, what is MAD? MAD means, MAD is means mean absolute deviation. Then MSE means mean square error. Then RMSE means root mean square error. Okay, let us see how to do the MAD, MSE, and the RMSE. Okay, you can see here MAD equal to average absolute residual. Okay, average residual. Okay, means that you see, you just need to write the average, then you just click from E3 until E45, then you will get the answer here. Okay, this one is the value of the MAD. Okay, how to do the MSE? How to do MSE? You can see the formula here. You just need to type average square residual. Okay, how to do also same like just now. You just need to type average, then select from F3 until F45, then you will get the MSE value, which is here, this one. Okay, and after that, what is the formula of RMSE? RMSE is square root of MSE. Okay, square root of MSE is very easy only. You just need to click, then you just need to click here, then you write, you type equal SQRT means square root, then F45. F45 is MSE value. Okay, just click here, then you get the RMSE value. Okay, after get the RMSE value, we need to go up here. We need to highlight the first column. Because this is the initialized first, you need to initialize the first column. Okay, based on our questions, we need to find out the other 4 months. So you need to find the other 4 months is October, November, December, and January. Okay, just drop down. Then also the forecast data also you need to drop down 4 columns because you need to find out the other 4 months for the forecast data. So remember to highlight this one because this is the question required. Okay, after we done all the things, all the data we have to find out already. So the RMSE does not mean it is suitable for these questions, and the alpha also not maybe it's not suitable for this question, so we need to use the solver to solve it to choose the best value for the RMSE and the alpha. So before I proceed to the how to do the solver, I will say sorry first because this laptop is not mine, so I also don't know why the data there didn't have any solver. So I just use the PowerPoint. Oh yeah, I just use the PowerPoint to present the part of solver how to use. Okay, so let us start. Okay, first you need to go top here. You just find out the word is data. Just find the data, then you just click it. After that, you go here and to find out the word solver. You just click. Okay, then you will come out like a box like that. Okay, you just go to the set objective there. You just click the RMSE value, means that is this one. You just click it. Then choose the minimum. don't choose the maximum because they have two choices. You need to choose, you must to minimize the RMC. So you need to choose minimum. Okay. You go to the, okay, after that, you go to the changing variable cells. You go there and you choose, and you click here. Click the alpha value and the 1 minus alpha value. Okay. After that, you go to the subject to the constraint there. They have maybe before that you have used or what they have some value or equation, you just delete it or become blank. After that, you go to the right hand side there. They have a word add. You just click it, then you can add the alpha and 1 minus alpha, which means that is this one 0.7 and 0.3. Then you choose less than and equal. Then the constraint choose one. Okay, repeat the step. You click add, click the alpha and 1 minus alpha, then choose large than and equal. Then this one must be changed because just now you used the less than, so now you use the large than and equal. Then the constraint you choose zero. Okay, why we need to choose one constraint to choose one to zero? Because the alpha value is only between the zero and one, so we need to choose zero and one only. So after done all the step here, then you just click the save. Click the save. After you click the save, the value will come up. Okay. Eh, why is same? Oh, because this data is didn't use the solver. We use the solver data here is here. Okay, we can see the value of RMSE is changed, and the alpha also from 0.7 changed to 0.69, and the alpha 1 minus alpha also from 0.3 become increased already become 0.31. Okay, this is difficult to see the RMSE changing, so I have do a table like that to let you see the changing of the RMSE and alpha. Okay, before we using the solver, the RMSE is 11357258.08. After using the solver, the RMSE is increased already, so become the 11358080.27, and the alpha decreased already from 0.7 become 0.69. Okay, we will use the value of RMSE and alpha is after using solver. Okay, this one is more suitable for us to use in our creations. So why we will choose the value here? I will pass to the another members to explain why we choose this RMSE value and alpha value. She will present the part of conclusion. So that's all for me. So thank you for your watching. Okay, bye.